Russia, there is something special. A lot of traffic jams, but fortunately, the main speakers, the key speakers, they have come. So let me officially announce opening time for this session. So let me introduce key participants among organizers of this roundtable discussion for education and training to support emerging nuclear countries. My name is Vladimir Artishuk. I'm from Obninsk, from Central Institute for Continuing Education and Training. Юрий Алексеевич, зайдите в президиум, а то мы умрем здесь. Серьезно, Юрий Алексеевич, ну. Значит, let me introduce my colleagues. Mr. Karezin, Department of Human Resource Development, State Atomic Energy Corporation, Rosatom. Mr. Krupski, Human Resource Development of Rosenergoatom, the main Russian utility. Professor Krychkov, Vice Rector of National Research Nuclear University, MEFI. So, dear foreigners, dear foreign colleagues, you are in Russia and you have to investigate for yourself specifics of Russian culture. Russia, that is rather national country, so many of speakers, don't be surprised, will speak Russian language. And we appreciate your understanding of Russian language and at least your kind attitude to Russian speakers. So, just few words about meaning of this session. So, prospects of nuclear education in the countries embarking on or expanding their nuclear power programs. The target of this session is to formulate recommendations in supporting the national programs and human resource development for emerging nuclear countries. And areas for discussion are listed here as follows. To investigate best practices in human resource development for emerging nuclear countries, to demonstrate the approach of State Atomic Energy Corporation, Rosatom, to cooperation activities in developing human resources for emerging nuclear countries, and to exchange information on current status and trends. Personally, I'm very much interested in the following slide. You see, nowadays a lot of forums, international conferences ongoing concerning human resource development in new entrance countries. And one of the most important among the first forums were a technical meeting on topical issues on infrastructure development last year, February. It was a remarkable meeting. They separated participants of this meeting for several groups and asked them to elaborate the key issues to be discussed in the area of human resource development. And this slide demonstrates the expectation from developing countries. Look, step by step. Vendor should provide a vision to newcomer. The newcomer countries need additional information in terms of seminars, training, courses from vendors. The information regarding operators and regulatory body should be provided by vendors of their corresponding organization in the country of the vendor. So we understand here in Russia a lot of responsibility on our shoulders concerning vendor responsibility. So, not so many vendors in the world, Russia one of the key vendors, and so, dear foreign colleagues, please percept our attitude to you, and dear Russian colleagues, demonstrate your kindness to future and potential recipients. I would like to give the floor for the opening remarks to State Atomic Energy Corporation, Rosatom, Mr. Karezin, Department of Human Resource Development.
Уважаемые гости выставки, российские и зарубежные коллеги, от имени Департамента управления персоналом госкорпорации «Росатом» я вас приветствую на этом форуме. Форум, который, как подчеркнул господин Артисюк, является для нас очень важным мероприятием, которое позволит понять, каким образом российское образование, каким образом сотрудничество в области подготовки кадров может помочь нам в достижении целей использования мирного атома. Я хотел бы подчеркнуть один очень важный аспект нашего сотрудничества. Аспект, заключающийся в использовании тех мощностей университетов России, представителей которых я здесь вижу, которые приехали из всех городов Российской Федерации, в которых есть университеты, в которых есть учебные программы, позволяющие обучать новейшим технологиям с использованием новейших достижений науки и технологий Российской Федерации. И я хотел подчеркнуть, что госкорпорация будет делать все возможное для того, чтобы наладить эффективное международное сотрудничество. Мы приглашаем преподавателей, мы приглашаем студентов учиться в российских университетах, овладевать современными технологиями использования мирного атома. Мы готовы рассматривать разумные варианты сотрудничества и, безусловно, все, что мы будем делать в этом направлении, будет взаимовыгодно и будет во многом способствовать нашему дальнейшему мирному сотрудничеству. Спасибо.
Спасибо. I would like to give you a brief list of participants, of key participants of this session. Of course, State Atomic Energy Corporation, Rosatom, the leading organization, the umbrella for all the activity in Russia related to peaceful use of nuclear energy. National Research Nuclear University, MEFI, the leading organization in educating specialists for nuclear sector. National Research University, Tomsk Polytechnical University, one of the famousest organization with a long history to educate people for nuclear industry. Central Institute for Continuing Education and Training, director of my organization, Mr. Selesnev. Concern Rosenergoatom, Mr. Krupski, who is now in the process of summarizing of this kind of activity, and also representative of Balakovsky Nuclear Power Plant, Mr. Birdugin, who will give you a talk on the experience of Russian training centers to train specialists for foreign nuclear power plants. International Atomic Energy Agency, Mr. Hadid Subki, head of the section for small reactors. World Nuclear University, Mr. Adrian Collins, are you here? Okay, maybe. He's coming. And we have representatives from potential recipient countries like Bangladesh, Singapore, Vietnam, and also representative from the vendor country. Mr. Runge, are you here?
Yes, perfect, perfect.
So let me give the floor to the representative of International Atomic Energy Agency, Mr. Subki.